back. Molly Horton is not 99, by the way.
After watching the film of the game, any what are your takeaways about your performance and the offense?
We actually finished up yesterday. We just got to make some plays at the end of the day. I got to be smarter with the ball. I wish I could go back and redo some plays, but you only get one shot, and you live and you learn. You got to move on, and we're just focused on this week, 1-0. So, looking forward towards Southern Miss.
How different was last week knowing that there was a chance you were going to play all week as opposed to maybe what happened last year where all of a sudden you're thrust in on a moment's notice against Houston?
I wouldn't say it really wasn't a difference for me because I come out here every day preparing like I'm the starter, just trying to get better each and every day, putting myself in the best position to help the team win. And I'm just here to do whatever the team needs me to do and put us in a winning position. I just remember we started off really good, and then we came out in the second half kind of slow, and we kind of let off, and we just got to come out faster in the second half and just keep on that pedal and finish the game strong like we come out in the first half.
And they did a little bit of celebrating. Obviously, it's a tradition in the rivalry. How much does that make
you
add motivation?
It definitely adds motivation, especially coming off of a loss. It just motivates us more to do extra work to where we don't have to feel that again. Just come out every day prepared, put that behind us, and just look forward to this week and just, like I said, going 1-0 and getting better and doing what we can to win this week.
From what you've seen them done so far, like, what are your impressions of
some of this? They're a great team. They have a really good secondary. They run a heavy blitz package. They have a lot of exotic blitzes. Got to do a really good job with seeing that and just getting us into the right looks and right looks up front. But just overall, they're a good team and looking forward to playing them.
If you had one that you'd like to do over Saturday?
It would obviously be the interception. Just a bad misread on my part. If I put the ball in the right spot, it's a touchdown. So just got to look back on that, learn from it, and move on. And like I said, just get ready for this week.
Obviously, I know you're friends with Michael Pratt, and obviously you want to see him healthy. But every opportunity you get, no matter how it comes, like, how much do you cherish like the opportunity that you got on Saturday?
Yeah, I cherish every moment of it. I came here to play football. I love Mike, like he's my brother, like a big brother. He helps me out all the time, but like I said, I came here to play football, and any opportunity I can get, I'm going to try to take the most of it and just do what I can to help the team win. And, yeah.
Was it an easy decision for you to stay here after last year? I mean, some people these days, people are transferring really illy almost.
Yeah, no, it was an easy decision. I love Coach Nagel. He's a great offense coordinator. He's done a really great job with me this offseason, just helping me understand a lot of stuff, getting me in better shape, getting me ready to play. And just like I said, he just helps me understand things in such a more simpler way to where I can just go out there and play fast and not really worry about what's going on in my head. And he just does a great job with all of us, helping us play simpler and just making sure that we're knowing what we're doing when we go out there.
So you were happy when he was named offensive coordinator?
Oh, yeah.
You're direct.
No doubt. I love Coach Nagel, and I love his offense and just everything he does with us, and just coming out pushing us every single day to just get better and just not come out here lacking, no matter if it's hot, cold, raining. He just pushes us every single day to just be better, and I appreciate that.
Kai, the one that you threw to Keys early in the game, the big play, mm-hmm. You had to kind of fit it in there in a lot of traffic. Would you have let that one fly a year ago, or do you think that was more of a confidence throw than
Yeah, that's definitely more of a confidence throw. And like I said, with Coach Nagel, he's helped us a lot with like just seeing coverages in the back end. I saw what coverage they were running, and I just knew I had to just wait just a tad second to just get that dig window open. They ran a form of three to the field, and I just knew that if I just held on to the ball, no matter if I was about to get hit or not, just for that window to open up, and I knew it was going to be open, and Keys made a really great play, and like you said, it was a big play. So.
Yeah,